Good morning guys, myself Sandeep Kumar Reddy from Ingenious Competitive Training Academy. Today we will be discussing about the computer concerning multiple choice. I had already discussed up to part 15. I request you guys to check my playlist where you will find up to part 15. So let us see what exactly these question papers are given in this concerning to the computer's terminology. The process by which computers manipulate data into formation, that process is known as, that is, processing. So in this processing, what happens? That computer directly manipulate data into the information. So whatever we feed in as through input, that is a data, that directly converts into the information. So that is by the processing. Next we have errors. In a computer, program are referred as, whatever the errors we have in the computers, those errors are known as bugs. Don't tell those errors are mistakes, they are all bugs. Whatever the errors in computer language, that terminology is bugs. A computer hard disk is, we knew that in a computer we have the hard disk. That hard disk is a computer hardware. So that is one type of a hardware, it is not a software. Whatever we can touch, that is a hardware. Next we have arithmetic logic unit, that is for the mathematical calculation purpose. Operating system, we knew that Linux and Windows, these are all one type of operating systems. So you should know each and everything whatever you are reading in this chapter. A compiler is used to translate a program written in computer software. We knew that whatever the compiler it is, that is used for the translating a program written in a computer software. So that is, you have to remember that. So that is the main purpose, is to encrypt that. Next we have, in programming you use the following keys, that is arrow keys. As you can see the arrow keys, we knew that upper arrow, lower arrow and left and right arrows, these are all arrow keys. These are used in the programming. In the case of functional keys, we have from F1 to F12, and alphanumeric keys, we knew that A to Z and 0 to 1, 1 to 0, these are all alphanumeric keys, but these are not used in the programming. Nibble, please remember guys, we knew that every byte we have 8 bits, every nibble we have 4 bits. It means every byte we have 2 nibbles. So this is what you have to remember. So you can directly go through whatever has been given. 1 byte is equal to 8 bits. Next we have, a memory in a PC is addressable through, that is, byte. Please, in our personal computer, that is addressable through the byte. The resolution of a monitor is measured in dots per inch. This is what exactly you have to remember. DPI. Whatever the monitor's resolution, which is measured in the dots per inch, DPI. If we say in a printer, it is print per inch, print per page. So this is what you have to remember for the every page. Here dots per inch is measured in the monitor's resolution. Next we have Windows and Macintosh computers, they are not compatible. Windows is different and Macintosh PC is different. They are not at all compatible. Arithmetic operations, we knew whatever the arithmetic operations, that is maximum we do it in arithmetic logic unit, that is ALU. So that is, which includes addition, subtraction and multiplication, which directly we can go through that. DBMS, that is database management system, this software allows users to perform calculations on rows and columns of data. So whatever the calculations concerning to the rows as well as columns, that is DBMS. Next we have, 10 to the power of 9 represents approximately 1 billion memory, that is 13 locations. As you can see here, that gigabyte, megastar means 10 to the power of 6. In the case of gigastar, that is 10 to the power of 9. Here this gigabyte represent approximately 1 billion memory, that is 13 locations. So this is what gigabyte. cells involves creating a single cell by two or more selected cells, that is known as merging. In this merging process, what happens? Whatever the cells we select, that will be in a single cell. This is what merging. A data warehouse organized around important subject areas. This is one thing you have to know, what exactly the data warehouse is, that is organized around important subject areas. Next, we have file servers store and manage files for network users. So dash servers, that is file servers that store and manage files for network users. Next, we have the examples of real security privacy risks except spam. So please remember what exactly the real security privacy risks that except spam is the one. An output device that uses words or messages recorded 18 on a magnetic medium to produce audio response is magnetic tape. So this is one output device. That uses words or messages recorded 18, as you can see, recorded on a magnetic medium to produce audio response is magnetic tape. So this is one thing you have to remember. Which of the following will happen when data is entered into a memory location? It will erase the previous content. So this is what exactly happens when the data entered into a memory location. So what are the previous content we have that automatically gets erased? The difference in speed at which of the different units can handle data, that is in the case of buffer, we can see the difference in speed. So here you have to remember, a storage used to restore data compensate for the difference in speed at which the different units can handle data is buffer. One terabyte consists of how many bytes? Gigabytes. We knew that 1 TB hard disk we have, that is 1024 gigabyte. So please remember 1 TB is equal to 1024 GB. Select the smallest memory size. Kilobyte is the one among all these is the smallest. Terabyte is the biggest. Control Alt Shift. These are all three keys which are known as modifier keys. Please remember, you should know arrow keys, upper, lower, left and right arrows. They are the arrow keys, functional keys from F1 to F12. Modifier keys, they are Control, Alt and Shift. These are the control keys, that is modifier keys. What is the permanent memory built in your computer called, that is ROM is one type of permanent nature, RAM is temporary one. So ROM is a permanent nature. The memory which is almost accessible to the processor, that is cache memory is the one which is almost accessible to the processor, that is cache memory. CD-ROM, that is one type of magnetic disk, but if you had asked only CD, compact disk, it is an optical device. It is a CD-ROM, read-only memory, it is a magnetic disk. What type of device is a computer printer, that is output device? Nowadays, what are the printers we have? That is multi-device, in which you have the scanner as well as the output for the printing. So that is multi-type of device. Even in my office, that is a multi-device. To move the beginning of a line of text, press home key. So please remember, whatever the beginning of a line of text, that is you have to press the home key initially. For creating a document, you use new command at file menu. So please remember, whatever the you are creating the document, you use the new command at file menu. So we have to create the new one, then only we can rename that. The contents of memory are lost when the computer is turned off. So as whatever the content we have, if you don't save it, and automatically that can be lost. Which of the following memories has a shortcut access time? that is cache memory has got the shortcut access time. So this has got the shortcut access time, that is cache memory. A bit microprocessor has the word length equal to, that is 4 bytes. Whatever the microprocessor that has the word length equal to the 4 bytes. So next we have RFID, that is one thing. Tags when placed on an animal can be used to record and track in a database all of the movements. We knew that RFID means radio frequency identification. This is what you have to remember. These type of trackers will be placed on a aquatic animals or any kind of animals. That is radio frequency identification, RF. It works on the electromagnetic field and we can easily monitor the respective animals. A set of information that defines the status of resources allocated to a process is known as process description. This is one thing you have to remember, guys. This process description is a set of information that defines the status of resources that allocated to a process. Any method for controlling access to or use of memory is known as memory protection. What exactly the memory protection is? It's any method for controlling access to or use of memory is known as memory protection. Software applies arithmetic, also called as algorithms, to process data. This is what you have to remember. What exactly that software applies arithmetic, also called as algorithm, to process data. A file extension is separated from the main file but no spaces. That is, as you can see, it is not given in it. So the file extension is separated from the main file but no spaces, it is not at all given in it. So it is not the answer, none of the above. An ad hoc query is a pre-scheduled question. What exactly ad hoc query means? Whatever the pre-scheduled questions we have, that is known as ad hoc query. An interrupt handler is a special numeric code that indicates the priority of a request, which is interrupt handler. It is a special numeric code that indicates the priority of a request. Next we have a spooler is a program that coordinates the print jobs that waiting to be printed, which is known as a spooler. What exactly the spooler is? Program that coordinates the print jobs that waiting to be printed. Next we have virtual memory is typically located, that is, on the hard drive. This is what exactly virtual memory is. Typically located on the hard drive is a virtual memory. The purpose of a swap file is to hold a program's data or instructions in virtual memory when it cannot be fitted in RAM. That is known as, here the purpose of the swap is to hold a program's data or instructions in virtual memory when it cannot be fitted in RAM. Next we have, what exactly the definition of thrashing is? That is swapping data between virtual memory and RAM too frequently. So whatever this is, what the swapping data between this virtual memory and as well as the RAM too, both these frequently, is known as thrashing. Next we have the protocols. We have TCP and IP. This is one thing. This is one type of network, that is ICMP. That is ICMP type of network. Next, as usual, TCP stands for Transfer Control Protocol, Internet Protocol. What exactly SNMP stands for? Simple Network Management Protocol is what? SNMP. Simple Network Management Protocol. Here we have on a school computer, Lucy Lerner, how to copy programs. A classmate asked her to copy a program. In this, I can't comply it because it will break copyright laws. This is one thing. On a school computer, Lucy learned how to copy programs. A classmate asked her to copy a program. It is violation of the school's copyright. Next we have, which of the following is not true? That is, logo abbreviation is not true. That is, language of graphics oriented is the abbreviation of logo, but it is given as a live on Google circuit is wrong. Here Grub is a Linux boot loader. Ruby is a web scripting language. Lilo is a Linux boot loader. These are all correct, but logo's abbreviation is wrong. Next, dash terminals. Here we have point of scale, POS, is a terminals. So this is one thing you have to remember. Often connected to computers, inventory and sales computer system, that is point on sales is the one which is often connected to computer, inventor and sales computer systems. Next we have small program that helps to automate frequently used series of commands in most productivity, that is micro is a small program. Here this is whatever has been given, that is frequently used series of commands in most productivity. What exactly the multi-thread means? It is one program doing more than one thing at a time, that is known as multi-thread. So it is a type of multiple tasking. Thank you guys. I hope all these 50 questions will help you a lot in understanding few things. You may got these questions. They are all previous year questions. Thank you. Have a good day. Have a great life.